Hey everybody, it's Pete Ward here from The Pete Ward Show. Now, I've had an interesting afternoon. I hope you're having an interesting afternoon. It is Friday here in New Zealand, if you're watching this from anywhere else other than New Zealand. Now, what's going on? I'm on here talking to you today about how much is it worth for your website to be hacked. Now, the reason I'm on here talking about that is I've just spent the better part of most of the day and let's say getting into four figures fixing up someone's hacked website. Okay, so you've spent all of this amazing time building a website, checking everything out, making sure it's perfect. I mean, it looks pristine and you might have, the budget you've spent, who knows? The budgets range, you know, some people spend $20,000 on their website, some 50, some people spend $2,000 on their website. My issue is once you've spent the money, everyone just kind of walks away and goes, I've got a website now, and they forget about it. Now, that's just crazy because it's like buying a car, not taking it to get service, not filling up the oil, checking the oil, filling up the water, making sure your window wiper washer is filled up, all of those sort of things. It's a pretty obvious kind of analogy. You can see what I'm saying. This is your business livelihood. This is the front door calling card for every business. Everyone jumps on and searches your website. And what happens? What happens to come up? Now, see, today what happened was, and I'm obviously never going to disclose who it is, but essentially they started with one problem, which escalated into many problems. So the Japanese SEO hack. Has your website turned into a whole lot of Japanese URLs? If you search on Google right now, search your website, just not with the .co.nz or whatever it is, .com on the end, but just search your name on there, and if your website comes up and then underneath you've got Japanese characters all the way through, you have been hacked with the latest SEO hack. Now, what's going on there is basically they've got access to your website, they've uploaded some files in there, they may have even added users to the search console. Now, the Google search console is the first place to go to check it out, okay? And you might find a whole lot of new users in there, a whole lot of new URLs, and they're all in Japanese. Leaping back to where I started with, how much is that worth to you? The company that I've just been working with, they are going to have to start again afresh, because when I looked into it, I found a two-year-old hack called WebShell. Now, WebShell is very interesting. They get in there through non-updated websites, okay? So you might have bought a license for a plugin or got the free one. You haven't gone in and updated it. You don't know what's going on in your website. They certainly do. They're in there. They're searching for these outdated plugins and outdated software. Anything that's outdated, they know how to get in. They're in there. And basically what they did is then they installed multiple backdoors into this website. So through the web shell, anyone can get in there. Sorry, I actually haven't got my phone sitting here, so I can't see if anyone's on here. So hello if anyone is watching, and thank you very much. And if you've got comments, I'll reply to you when I get off the stream. But basically, where I started was I've just spent most of the day and seriously up into four figures working on someone's hacked website. Now, what is your website worth to you? Is it worth more than that? It could be worth five figures. It's your calling card. It's the first thing that you want people to see, and you want it to looking good when they search you on Google. Is it hacked? I tell you what you do about it. You start a maintenance plan. Now, of course, obviously, I can do a maintenance plan for you. I sort your website out. I do your plugins. I do your backups. I make sure, you know, weekly, monthly, whatever it is you need. Don't leave it more than monthly, I can tell you. If you need it daily, we can get in there and do whatever it is. Okay, so because I'm Pete Ward, I'm that online guy. Basically, how much is your website worth to rebuild from scratch? Because essentially the company that I'm dealing with today is going to have to start from scratch, rebuild their whole entire website, upload all the plugins again from scratch. That's the only way to know that they're fresh and they haven't been tampered with, they haven't been hacked, and that's what they're going to have to do. So look, if you've got an issue with the Japanese SEO hack at the moment where all of your website turns up in Google Japanese, or you think there might be something going on, or you just want to be really, really safe and secure, get in touch, find out how to contact me. If you're looking at this on LinkedIn, you can PM me, you can do all sorts of things on Facebook. Get in touch, I'll give you a price on how I can make sure that your website is securely looked after with a maintenance plan, so this kind of thing doesn't suddenly cost you 4 and 5 figures when you have to start again, because you've put a lot of work into your website and you don't want to have to start again. So I'm Pete Ward, I'm that online guy. Follow me to find all sorts of things about online. I can talk about, it's not just security, there's all sorts of stuff that I can tell you in the 20 odd years or more than 20 years that I've been online, and just, I love it. I love online, it's absolutely fantastic. So I'm Pete Ward, I'm that online guy. Look after yourself, it's Friday in New Zealand. Maybe knock off a little bit early if you can and go for corporate drinks or something like that, or maybe you work for yourself, to give yourself a little bit of a rest. But I tell you what, don't think that you can get away from this issue, because the hackers are on there 24/7 looking for you.
Adriana,
oh, here we go.
Said, this is great. Thank you for sharing.
Oh, thank you, Adriana. Thank you very much. And yeah, that's really good. So yeah, check your website, get a maintenance plan in place, make sure you look after yourself. Thank you. All right, so it's Pete Ward Show. I'm Pete Ward. Have a great weekend, and I'll catch you in the next episode.